Please, please, have your seat. There is a good question. So, no? The question is, all those cognitive series, no? Cognitive series consciousness, do they arise in the eye-door, or no? They also arise in the mind-door? So, in the Park Forest Meditation Centers, no? So the meditators, they have to observe these cognitive series. No? They have to observe them. So when they observe them, they have to see the eye door and the mind door together. No? So when you attain the jhana, you can see the chakku prasada. No? When we say the eye door, you have to see chakku prasada. And then the mind door, puvinga citta. And then you try to see a visible object, no? Striking the eye door, and then that visible object, no? Appears in the eye door and the mind door together. So actually it appears in both doors. Now we say, no, it appears in the mind, in the eye door first, so we get tinada. So these are bringa jita cut off, and then remember panja dwara vachana. No, panja dwara vachana will depend on the heart base for its arising. No, only chakku vinyana, dependent on the eye base that arise at the eye door. The eye door and the eye base are the same thing. So only chakku vinyana arise at the chakku prasada. And all the other chaita, no, they are mano vinyana chaita, they all depend on the heart base. The heart base is in the mind, in the heart of the blood, no? In the blood of the heart. So the only chakku vinyana arise in the eye, and all the other chaitas arise in the heart, depending on the heart base. But they take all that sense object that appear in the sense in the eye door. No, the sense object appear in the eye door is seen, no? It's take notice by the panca dwara vajana, and then chakku vinyana sees it, and we say, and also Abhidhamma says that only chakku vinyana can see, no, the visible object, and only the ear consciousness will hear the sound. No? So chakku vinyana see the sense object, and the sense object is, as I told you, it is passed, so transmitted from one consciousness to another. So they all take that sense object, the sense object, no, that arises here and appears here. So no, they all take that sense object. So we call them, they are all, no, the eye-door cognitive series. We don't say mind-door cognitive series. No, they arise in the heart, but not in the mind-door. Not in the mind-door. The mind-door is, no, for the, remember, the mind-door and the heart base are different. No, the mind-door is the Pringa Chaita. No, the heart base is, no, the heart base are different. So now each of these consciousness, they don't depend on the same heart base actually also. So now each of them they depend on the new heart base, no? And we will explain that later on. So now we go to the fourth case. Where's the fourth case? This is number two. Number four, we have to go to number four. So number three. Number four. Okay, here we get, no? The occurrence of ati preta ramana vithi. Ati preta means very slight. No, visible object of very slight, no, intensity strikes the eye door. No? And the object takes 10 to 15 conscious movement. So in Brihadaramana, it takes 4 to 9, no? conscious movement. Now if they stand to 15 conscious movement for its full development, so even then the intensity of the object is so slight that, no, as we say, it is a very slight intensity. So it is so slight that it causes the light, no, the continuum to only vibrate twice without becoming arrested. So that means, no, the Bohinga stream is not cut off at all. So no cognitive seed of consciousness arises. And the object is not known at all. No, because no the cognitive consciousness arises, it is not known at all. However, the following six VT forms can be written to represent the Atik Preta Ramana VT. So as usual, no, the consciousness, I think we have to change the battery. As usual, we see the sense objects. No, the strikes the eye at the arising moment of the first Adida Bhuinga. And only after, no, 10 conscious moment, the sense object become distinct, and then it causes the light continuum to vibrate, no, two times, na-na. So we don't say nada because Bhuinga stream is not cut off. So this nana is also bringa chitta. After vibrating two times, so only bringa, no, as the bringa stream is not cut off, only bringa chitta keep on arising. No, so up to here we get, no, the 17 conscious moment. So, no, after when the fifth, no, bringa chitta, after bringa jalana perishes, the sense object also perish. So now the cognitive series end here, and after that only Bhuinga Chitta keep rising. So in this five VT, we increase one Atita Bhuinga in the front and cut off one Bhuinga at the rear. So in at the same VT, we have 15 Atita Bhuinga and two Dada Lamana, Adi Bhuinga Chalana. So now the 17 conscious movement. So all these Chitta, no, they don't contain any cognitive consciousness at all, so we call them Moggavara Viti. Okay, we can read a little bit. As usual, please read. The sense object in the Chakkhupasada idol arise together at the arising moment of the first Atida Bhuinga. The sense object, being of very slight intensity, takes 10 to 15 conscious movement for its full development. When it is well developed, it appears at the eye door, but being very weak, it can cause the light continuum only to vibrate two times without breaking the stream of the light continuum. Thus, of the two Bhuinga Chalana Chaitas, only Bhuinga Chitta keep on arising or flowing. The sense object and the Chakkhupasada now will perish together at the end of sending conscious movements after their genesis. No, genesis and arising are the same. And so the object is not known at all as no Viti Chitta arise. And because these Vitis are deprived of Viti Chaita, they are known as Moggavara Vitis, Shutai Cognitive Series. So we say, now we finished the idol cognitive series, And not only for the other four Sendo cognitive series, it will be the same life here. No, we just change the eye door into the ear door, nose door, tongue door. And you change the eye consciousness into ear consciousness, you know, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, etc. No, just change that. And we also right here now. Now, no, the, there are 75 pancha dwara we teach. No, pancha dwara means five door, no, cognitive the series. In the process of cognition and the eye door, no, we have seen that there are one the dalamana vara viti for ati mahanda ramana, and then two javana vara viti for mahanda ramana, and then six vuttabana vara viti for prida ramana, and six moga vara viti here, six viti, no, we have seen here for ati prida ramana viti. So all together there are, no, so if you combine 6, 6, 2, 1 are all together 15 vitis at the eye door. Similarly, there are 15 vitis each at the ear door, the nose door, the tongue door, and the body door. Thus, the total number of pancha dwara vitis at the five doors is 75. No, 15 into 5 is 75. So in writing the viti form, no, the viti form, and explaining the forms for the ear door, Soda vinyana, so we write, no, the symbols, no, so. So for instead of chaku vinyana, cha, we write there. So it should be inserted in place of chaku vinyana, and sound and soda pasada should replace visible object and the chaku pasada, respectively. Similarly, proper changes should be made, no, for the termination of three doors. For the remaining three doors. So we finished here. And now the simile, no, the simile of a mango fruit. So that longest viti, the Ati Mahanda Ramana viti, no, is compared with the falling of a mango fruit. So, no, suppose a very weary traveler, no, so he is asleep at the foot of a mango tree. And this state of being, sleep, is analogous to the quiet flow of life continuum in Ati Mahanda Ramana Viti. So, not say we say traveler, he left his house in the morning, so he went on a very long journey, so he walked, not for 6 hours, so up to the noontime. So he became very tired. And he also used up his food already, no, his food and water used up. So now he want to rest. When he saw a mango tree with very good shade, so now he went down into the shade. And then as there's a little breeze, he became sleepy. So now he slept at the root, no, the, so putting his head on the root of the mango tree, he sleep and fall asleep. So when he falls asleep, paccitta arising. When you are asleep, paccitta will be arising. Buhinga chitta, only buhinga chitta will arise. So no, it is just like buhinga chitta arising when he is asleep. So at that time, there are, no, some ripe mangoes, no, on the mango tree. So as there's a slight breeze, so one mango, no, drop to the ground, so it, no, it make the sound, boom, so it make the sound. So, no, the mango falls quite close to near his head, so he wakes up. So, no, that means the mango fruit, no, it strikes in the ground, making the, no, making the sound. It's the same thing, the striking of the visible object at the eye door. Strike the eye door, and then because of this sound strike at the eye door, no, and then we see after one conscious moment, the same object become distinct. No, the same object become distinct. When it become distinct, we say, no, Buhinga stream vibrates, start vibrates. Remember, vibrates two times. So the same thing now, because of the sound of, no, the the mango fruit striking the ground. The man wakes up, and then he raises his head. He doesn't open his eye yet, so raises his head just like the vibrating of the Bohinga, same for two times. And then he opened his eye. So that is the same thing as the Bohinga stream is cut off. After vibrating two times, Bohinga stream is cut off. So after he opened his eye, he tried to see. Now what makes the sound? What is that? So he looked around. And it is like just like Panja Dwara Vajana. Now try to take notice of the sense object. And then he sees the mango fruit. So it is like the Chaku Vinyana sees the visible object. Then he picks up the mango tree, and that is also like Samrichana Chaita receiving the sense object. And then after picking the mango fruit, what he eat right away? No. So he had to examine where there's some rotten space or something, something. He look around, and that is just like Sandirana investigating the sense object. Then he decides, it's good to eat. It's good to eat. So like what Tabana decide, the sense object is good. So as he was hungry, as he can to eat, so he made very big bites, seven bites. The whole chaita is finished, the whole mango is finished, seven times. So it is like the seven jhavana arising and enjoying in the taste of the sense object. So as the mango fruit, the flesh are all eaten, so he can throw away the seed, but there are still some why he was chewing it. Some of them are still remain on the teeth. And then what did he do? So he tried to collect this with his tongue, and then with the saliva he swallowed it. So that is like the Dalamana, following the Javana Chaita and also enjoying the taste of the sense object. So now he finished eating everything. So as he was still sleepy, so he put down his head again and fall asleep. That is Bohinga Chaita keep arising, we say. Okay, So now we also have some more with the cognitive series. So we say that the next object is here, I think. So where are we? Here or that's here. So there is the cognitive consciousness at five doors. So Panja Dwaravichi Chaita. So the cognitive consciousnesses, cognitive chaita that arise in the five doors. So we read again, if we examine the Panja Dwaravichi, we shall notice that seven types of consciousness participate in the cognitive series. The seven types of cognitive series are, so we have to take the first, the Ati Mahandaramana, which have the greatest, all the cognitive consciousnesses. So we begin with the Panja Dwaravajana, cognitive consciousness, and then Panja Vinyana, Samrechana, Sandirana, Uttabana, Javana, Dadalamana. Remember all in this order. So how many types? So the numbers of chaita that participate in the longest viti. The longest viti, that is Ati Mahandara viti, are how many? Seven, So seven conscious movement. So we write it down here. So Panja Dwaravajana is one, it arises only one time. And then Panja Vinyana one, Samrechana one, Sandirana one, and Vatthapana one, and then and Javana seven times, and the Dalamana arises two times. So altogether 14 consciousness arises in that cognitive series. So the total number of jhita that can participate now in the Panchadwara Vithi. So there are now 14 consciousnesses performing those seven the function actually. And then if you try to take the total number of jhita that can participate now in the Panchadwara Vithi So as the Panchadwara Vajana, we have only one. So for the Pancha Vijnana Chaita, no, for the five doors, so for the eye door, there will be two eye consciousness. No, but remember, no, the consciousness can arise only one at a time. So we say if the consciousness, the sense object is pleasant, so it would be due to our good karma, we see the pleasant sense object. So at that time, moral result then eye consciousness will arise. So if the sense object is unpleasant, so it is due to our in moral karma, so at that time, in moral eye consciousness will arise. So now when we try to see all the chaita that arise in WT, so we have to take, so there are two eye consciousness. And two ear consciousness, two nose consciousness, two tongue consciousness, two body consciousness. For 10 doors, we get 10. No? For 5 doors, we say you get 10. It is there are the 10 Dvi Panja Vijnana Chaita. And there are also Samrechana Chaita, there are also two. For Sandhirana Chaita, there are 3 Chaita that can take part in cognition. And then Vottapana Chaita is Manodvara Vajana, only one. And we say Kama Javana Chaita, the total Javana Chaita are 29. So the Dalamana Chaita, so no, you have already counted the three Panja Sandhirana, so you have to count only 8 Mahavipaka Chaita. No? So remember here, no, in the chart again. No? So the same chart we had. So, no, here the Dalamana Chaita is performed by 3 Sandhirana Chaita and 8 Mahavipaka Chaita. So as 3 Sandhirana already counted, so we just count 8 Mahavipaka Chaita. No, 8 Mahavipaka Chaita. So the total number of Chaita are 54. So these are all Kama, no, Kama Chaita. So we say, no, these are the 54 Kama Vajra Chaita. If we count the chaita for a single door, no, so instead of, no, for example, the eye door, we get only 2 chakku vijnana chaita instead of 10, no, the pancha vijnana chaita in 1B. So here, instead of 10, if you take only for one door, you have to write only 2. So how many chaita will you get for the 2 door? You have to subtract 8, no, so you get only 46. So the total number of chaita is 46. So this agrees with the number shown on page 100 of chapter 3. Note that vinga chaitas are not included in viti chaita. When you count the cognitive consciousness, now you have to leave not the vinga chaita. So we have already seen that. So in chart below here, 4.3. So we say, no, the number of chaita that arise in each door. So remember, in the eye door is 46, in the ear door 46. So these are the same chaita, not the same chaita. So you get 46. For 5 door, it would be 54. No, so we get that also. Now again, no, we have to. So we have to do some more thing. The object and the base taken by each viti chaita. So what are the chaita they take, the each chaita take, and what is the material base that they depend on. So again, we describe again, we can read, all the panja dwara vachana viti chaita, no, the grasps or they take, no, the present sense object that exists in the sense door. So remember, no, the sense object, no, it arises at the rising moment of first atita buinga chaita. And then it exists for 17 conscious moment. And only when the two dalamana, second dalamana perishes, the sense object also perish. So during this 17 conscious moment, we say, you know, the sense object exists in the idol. So we call that not the present sense object. The present sense object that exists in the sense door. And the pancha vijnana chaitas are born, no, by pancha vatu. Pancha vatu means the five, no, the sense basis. So the chakhu vijnana chaita are born by chakhu vatu. Soda vijnana chaita are born by soda vatus, and etc. Why the mano vijnana chaita are born by hadya vatu? So in, you know, beside this 10 dvipanja vijnana chaita, all the remaining chaitas are called, you know, mano vijnana chaita, so they are born by hadya vatu. For illustration, all the idol cognitive consciousness of atimhanda ramana viti, you know, grasp the visible object that appears at the idol at the rising movement of the bhuinga chalana, no, bhuinga chalana. So, no, it becomes, no, actually at the rising movement of, it should be, no, or we say that's a visible object that appears. So, no, when it appears, mean, so it appears at the first, no, at the rising movement of bhuinga chalana. Remember, at the rising moment, bhuinga chalana, we say, no, bhuinga chaita, no, vibrates two times. So it starts vibrating, no, at the rising moment, bhuinga chalana, and dissolve at the dissolving moment of the second dadalamana chaita. The two chakhu vijnana chaita are born by the eye base chakhu vijnana, no, chakhu prasada, which has arisen together with the visible object at the arising moment of the atita bhuinga. So remember, we say, no, the visible object and the idol, they arise together at the arising moment of atita bhuinga. So, no, so that chakhu prasada, no, the idol, we say, is the chakhu prasada, they arise together with the sense object. So it has the same lifespan. No, these two, they have the same lifespan. So we say, no, with the visible object at the rising moment of atita bhuinga. So this eye base, which has the same lifespan, no, as the visible object, is called majjhima yuga vatu. Majjhima means, no, means middle, actually the middle, it means majjhima. So that means ayu is a lifespan. So they have the same lifespan. No? This the visible object and the chakhu prasada. No? The chakhu prasada, and also when I give you the example of striking in mat, we say, no? When the visible object, no, strikes the chakhu prasada, the eye base, no, eye door is chakhu prasada, so they strike there. So chakhu vijnana arises at the striking point, we say. The striking point is chakhu prasada. It is on the chakhu prasada. So now this visible object is present at that time, and eye consciousness arises at that point. So they are at the same place. So we say that eye consciousness will depend at that chakhu prasada. No, chakhu prasada, that is the present the eye door. It is also the eye base. It depends on that eye base. So they have the same lifespan, no? The eye consciousness and the chakhu prasada, no? They have the same the visible object and the chakhu prasada, the eye door, no? They have the same lifespan. And so we say, not that eye base, which has the same lifespan as a visible object, is called majjhima yuga vatu. And those eye bases which have arisen earlier than the visible object. Now, if they arise earlier than visible object, no, they will perish earlier than the visible object. No, because all materiality have 17 conscious movement as their lifespan. No, they have 17 lifespan. So if they arise earlier, so they will also perish earlier. And these, you know, and thus, so those eyebases, you know, these eyebases, which arisen earlier, so were perished earlier, you know, and then they are known, you know, these are known as the physical basis of shorter lifespan. Manda yuka watu. Manda means shorter. So as the arise earlier than, you know, the visible object, so they seem to have, you know, their lifespan shorter than the visible object. So the eye consciousness does not depend on that this manda yuka watu. And also those watu, you know, which arise later than the visible object. So, and thus they will dissolve later than the visible object. And they are known as the physical basis of longer lifespan. Ah, manda yuga watu. No, as they perish only after the visible object perish, they seem to have longer lifespan. So they are called amanda yuga watu. And the eye consciousness depends only on the eye base, which has the same lifespan as the visible object. No, that means they depend only on that the majjhima yuga watu that have the same lifespan. So can you show chart number six, chart number nine? No, chart number nine. The lower part. So remember, when the karma, no, produced is a result in consciousness. So now the life, this is a rebirth consciousness, and these are the life continuum consciousnesses, no, one after another. And then, no, the karma also produce karma born materiality, and this materiality include the heart base, not the heart base. So now the heart base, so that arise together with the sense object, no. So they, no, they arise together with the sense object. They also perish, no, are together, as no, they all have the same conscious movement for their lifespan. And we call that majjhima yuga watu. If this the heart base, they arise earlier, like here, no, they perish before, no, the sense object perish. So they seem to have shorter lifespan. And then those who, no, those hadya watu that arise later than the sense object. Sense object arise here and they appear here, so they will perish only, no, later than the visible object. They seem to have the longer lifespan. So the eye consciousness do not depend on those, not on the two types of the hadya watu. They depend only on the majjhima yuga watu. As they arise together, you say, so it depends only on that, no, only that. Okay, we go, no, we go to the next. So where are we now? The lab. So we have to say, no, for the lifespan is, no, we are already finished. And how about the for the remaining pancha dwara viti chaitas? No, so all the remaining pancha dwara viti chaitas are mano vijnana chaita. So they are individually and respectively bound by the heart base. No, they all depend on the heart base, and which has arisen along with the preceding chaita. That is the heart base, which has lasted for one conscious moment. For example, pancha dwara vachana is bound by the heart base, which has arisen along with the vingu pachida. Sambarichana is bound by the heart base, which has arisen along with chakhu vijnana. Sandhyana is bound by the heart base, which has arisen along with sambarichana, jeda, so on. So now what you have to notice, all these mano vijnana chaita, no, they depend on the heart base. And which heart base they depend on? No? The question is, so they depend on the heart base, which has lasted for one conscious moment. So no, the heart base no, will arise one conscious moment earlier. And the reason is again here, no, for materiality, no, they, when they arise, no, at the time of rising, they are not stable yet. Not stable yet. Only when they come to the existing moment. So the arising moment of materiality is only one sub-moment, remember? One sub-moment. No? So we already said at the start of our no? When we say the lifespan of materiality, their lifespan is 17 consciousness moment. If you multiply by 3, you get 51. But their arising moment is only one sub-moment. And perishing moment are only one sub-moment. So we subtract not 2 from 51, we get 49. That is their existing moment. No? So, no, so now what do you get? So, and I said, no, at the arising moment, they are not stable yet. Only when they come to the existing moment, they become stable. So this, no, the consciousness that depend on the heart base, they depend on the heart base that have already lasted for one conscious moment. According to what we stated here. And that is why we say, can you show the upper atapa one? So no, this is actually Ati Mahanda Ramana Viti. No, Ati Mahanda Ramana Viti. No? So we say, no, the Pancha Dwara Vachana will depend on the heart base that arise together with this. No, this is, what is this? Vingu Pachida. No, which arise together with Vingu Pachida. And Samadhi Chana will depend on the heart base that arise along with Chakhu, that is eye consciousness, remember, Chakhu Vijnana. And Sandirana will depend on the heart base that arise with Samadhi Chana. So, not easy to remember, it depends on the heart base that have already lasted for one conscious movement. Just remember that, no? So now they are very, very, no, precise. No, we have to know everything in detail. No, when the Buddha he described. So at first we know that the Manodhara Vajana Chaita will depend on the heart base. So we don't differentiate which heart base. No? But now it pinpoints, you know, which heart base they depend on. So now we finish now, no, up to here. So we finished the five door cognitive series now. Now we can go to mind door cognitive series. No, when the sense object arises in the mind door, so cognitive series all will arise there. And then no, we say the mind door cognitive no, consciousness, VT, cognitive series. There are two kinds, no? Two kinds. One is kama, javana, vara, VT. So no, kama javana are arising as javana chaita. And here is apana javana vara viti, is apana javana chaita arising in the viti. So apana javana mean apana chaita, apana mean jhana mega phala. I told you once, no? So only when you attain the jhana, mega, and phala, the apana javana vara viti will arise. So no, so in other places, when we are just seeing the, not seeing and hearing the sense object, for example, so at that time only kama javana no chaita will arise. So that we can go down here. So these we will see later on. No, so when one of the six sense enter the avenue of the mind door, No, do the right like this. No, you just remember when one of the six senses appear in the mind door. No, you can just understand that. It does mean like that. Enter the avenue of the mind door. So it comes, no, it appears in the mind door. So mano dwara viti arises. Mano dwara viti may be first divided into two classes. Kama javana vara viti. Here, one of the 29 kama javana chaita, no, takes the function of javana, that is enjoying the taste of the sense object. No? And then apana javana vara viti means here one of the 26 apana javana, no, chaita takes the function of javana. So kama javana vara viti may further be divided into two types. So, no, the according to Abhidhamma Sangha, and also to four types, according to, no, so according to Lady Shadow, whereas apana javana vara viti may be subdivided into two types, namely Loki apana viti and Lokutra apana viti. So Loki apana means they are the jhana chaita. No? Rupavaja jhana and arupavaja jhana chaita. Apana viti, no, the Lokutra apana viti mean, no, Lokutra chaita arising as javana chaita, that is Megha and Phala. So all these viti will be explained below here. So according to the mind door, no, kama javana cognitive series, no, described in our book. So when we remember the presentation of sense object at the six sense door. So it is a little early, no? A little early. We have seen that. Page 110. No? So, at the page 110, at the bottom, we have the topic, six types of presentation of sense objects. So, there are four types of presentation sense objects in the five sense door. And then on page 111, no? So we have presentation of sense object at the mind door. You can see that? On page 111, the B, so the second paragraph. So there are only, no, presentation is only two kinds. What are they? One is weak Buddha Ramana, clear presentation of sense object, and another is weak Buddha Ramana Viti, obscure presentation of sense object. So according to Abhidhamma, not only the two types of presentation, so only two types of viti, and that two types of viti we describe here. Below here. No, we have to take this. So one is vibhuta ramana viti, no, clear presentation of the sense object. So, and then as, no, the, it terminates with the dalamana, we also call it the dalamana vara viti. And the other one is avibhuta ramana viti, no, obscure presentation of sense object. So no dadalamana, only it terminates with javana chaita, so we call it javana vara viti. And the form of viti is, no, very very short actually. So we say, no, the eye door is a mental door, and it is very powerful door when the sense object, no, appears in the mind door. As soon as, no, they come in contact with the mind door, they appear. We don't need atita bhinga. We don't need atita bhinga. So we say as soon as it appears in the mind door. So we, no, as we at, when the sense of object appears in the mind door, we get, no, the bhinga chaita, no, the normal vinga chaita that keep on arising, So when it arises at the arising moment of this Vrinda Chitta, so we get vibration of Vrinda Chitta, remember? No? So the Vrinda Chitta vibrates two times, Nanda. So in the Atita Vrinda, you know, we have, how is it the form? Tinada, there we have. So no, in the idol cognitive series, and then this one, here we already have here. So you have Atita Vrinda, no? So at the rising moment of this Atita Vrinda, we say sense object comes in contact with the idol. So only after one Atita Vrinda, it appears in the center, then we get Vrinda Jarana vibrates two times. Nada, and cuts off after nada, cuts off, and then it starts with Pancha Dwara Vachana, no? Like this. Now in the idol, so you have to show, no? They have to show chat number 4.2 again. And I think 4.3 is better, I think. So, okay. Now we have here, no? Mind door cognitive series. No? We already described this yesterday, actually. So when the object appears in the mind door, Mano Dwara Vajana, no, perform the avajana chaita, and then it will take notice of the sense object, and again it decides whether it's good or bad. Remember, Mano Dwara Vajana function two function, perform two function. Do you forget it? So in chapter number 4.2 about, no? Just chapter number 2, please. So here we say, no, the Mano Dwara Vajana perform two function. So it first perform avajana, no, it takes notice of the sense object, and then, no, it perform another function here. So here, so another function is Vottabana. It decides whether the sense object is good or bad. So after decision, no, we get Javana Chaita. No, after Vottabana, you get Javana Chaita and Dadalamana. So only these three types, no, three functions are performed in mind or cognitive series. So the 4.3 again. 4.3, so here we see in the mind or cognitive series. Now we begin with the Vottabana. So we say it apprehends the sense object and decides whether the sense object is good or bad. Then after that, no, the Kama Jhamana Chaita will arise. No, so enjoying the taste of the sense object, and then if the sense object is of great intensity, followed by the Dalamana Chaita, which also enjoy the taste of sense object, and finish only these three. So now we have only these three here. No, so these are Bhuvinga Chaita. So the sense object, no, so appears in the mind door. So we get, no, Bhuvinga Chaita vibrates two times and cut off. And then Manodwara Vajana, no, apprehend the sense object and decide whether it is good or bad. And according to that decision, no, one of the Kama Javana Chaita, so arises seven times, enjoying the taste of the sense object, followed by two Dadalamana Chaita. No, it is Vibhuta. No, so it is, we just say it is, no, the sense object of great intensity. So you get two Dadalamana and finish, only Vrinda Chaita keep arising. And then in the Avibhuta Ramana Chaita, no, the Viti. So Avibhuta means obscure presentation. The sense object is weaker than this one. So when the sense object is weak, we don't have the Dalamana. We have only when the sense object is, no, of great intensity, the Dalamana arises. So, no, in this second, we are Vibhuta Ramana. So we begin just like this, Na Dhamma, seven Jhamana. So we stop here. No, so we get only two Viti, no, for the according to Abhidhamma. Now the according to Our Lady Shadow. No, the Lady Shadow is a very learned monk, Myanmar monk, actually. No, so he actually, no, he appear, no, he appear in the world about 100 years ago, actually. And then in our the history of the Myanmar history, so he is the most learned monk, we might say. So at that time, we are still under the British the British rule when he appeared, and he was very learned. He have written more than 100 books. Now when he write books, he don't need to refer to the Tipitaka. He already got already by heart already. So he just stand up and just keep on writing, write. So you have to provide 100 the pencil, because one pencil he write. So so almost finished. So another pencil. So right. So very learned person. And then he can meditate very well. No, he can take he meditate, and he can also observe the ultimate reality. He can observe ultimate reality, and we believe that he can become really noble person. And he also attained the supernormal power. No, he can go to a place where immediately actually. So he is very learned actually. No. And then he has written also a book on the meditation, and I have the chance to read his book. So he emphasized in Vipassana, you must see only ultimate reality. If you are not seeing ultimate reality, you are just seeing still concept. Now, without seeing that, you are just trying to take note of any pain arising. So now pain, you are just meditating like that. That is not Vipassana, actually. No? So he said, we must see the ultimate reality arising and perishing very rapidly. Only then you can see they are impermanent, anicca, and then dukkha, and anatta. So you have to do that, he said. So as he can do by himself. So he said, also, the mind-dual cognitive series are four kinds, just like the eye-dual cognitive series. We have Ati Vibhuta. So he used instead of Vibhuta, he say Ati Vibhuta. That means very clear, very clear sense object appearing. So the same thing, just like here. So we get this at the first one, and then the next one he say Vibhuta Ramana. So that means fairly clear. So at that time, this is similar to this one. And then he said, we also, when we say, we Buddha, it is not clear, we say. So it is just like Preta Ramana in the idol cognitive series. So remember in the idol cognitive series, number 3, what are the cognitive consciousness you have? Remember you have 3 Vatthapana, wo, can you see that?
Yes.
Yes, please say that. Otherwise, I have to show you again. When the sense object is not very clear, now what happened? We say cannot decide whether it is good or bad. So when it cannot decide, no javana arises. So as no javana arises, what happened arises 2 more times. So you get bo 3 times. That is Vatthapana 3 times. The same thing here. So as the sense object is not very clear, it first, instead of wo, in Manodwara Viti, we use the symbol ma. Ma means Manodwara Vachana. Ma stands for Manodwara Vachana. And Vatthapana also stands for Manodwara Vachana. To differentiate, that is the Panjadwara Viti, this is Manodwara Viti, we use ma. So instead of wo 3 times, we say ma 3 times. So no javana chaita arise here. And in the 4, Ati Vibhuta, not clear. When it is very not clear, so the sense object is weak. So it can cause only vibration of the winga stream 2 times, nana, without cutting off the bringer stream. So no cognitive consciousness arises. So we don't know the sense object at all. So no, so for us, actually we prefer this. But now for your examination, you have to answer only this two. No, because in Abhidhamma, in the prescribed book, only these two are mentioned. Now explanation. So one of the six sense objects, which may be present, past, future, or time free. What consciousness are time free? Free from time. So yesterday when we say about the mind object, so we say the concept and Nibbana, they are independent of time. Remember, because the concept, actually they don't really exist. No, they don't really exist. And then the Nibbana always exists. So we cannot differentiate the past Nibbana, the present Nibbana, the future Nibbana. So we say they are independent of time. And now we say time free, the same thing. Time free and independent of time are the same thing. So remember yesterday we say all six types of sense object, including present sense object, past sense object, future sense object, can appear in the mind door, can appear in the mind door. To initiate the mind door, cognitive process. So when the sense object is of very great intensity, so we prefer to do this one. So the light continuum vibrates twice and becomes arrested, nada, and the appearance of the sense object at the mind door. The sense object appear. So on the appearance of the sense object and the mind door. So in other words, when we can write, when the sense object appear in the mind door, Bhunga stream vibrates two times and cut off. Then Manodwara Vachana, this Manodwara Vachana, na dhamma. So ma apprehend the object and directs the consciousness stream towards the sense object, observe the sense object and decides whether it's good or bad. In accordance with this decision, one of the 229 kama jhamana chaita perform the jhamana function for seven conscious moments, seven times, enjoying the taste of the sense object. The two dhalamana chaita follow follow suit, enjoying the taste of the sense object further. After that, do the dhalamana. So Bhuvinga Chaita will arise, will sink into life continuum. That means the Bhuvinga Chaita will keep on flowing. And then this Viti is known as Ati Vibhuta Ramana Viti, or as it terminates with the Dhalamana. So we call it the Dhalamana Vara Viti. Okay. So for the three of them, So this explanation also applies to the Vibhuta Ramana Viti, we describe here. Above there, this one. So they are the same, remember, the same thing. Here they call just Vibhuta Ramana Viti. And then the second one is the same like this one again. So now we call this Vibhuta Ramana, here it called Avibhuta Ramana Viti. So our continuation of this. Lab, okay. When the sense object is of fairly great intensity, the cognitive series occurs as above, but terminates with jhavana chitta, without the dhalamana. And this viti is known as Vibhuta Ramana Viti. Vibhuta Ramana Viti, or Jhavana Vara Viti. So it terminates with the Jhavana, so we call it Jhavana Vara Viti also. And note, the Avibhuta Ramana Viti here is taken as Vibhuta Ramana Viti, and Vibhuta Ramana Viti here is taken as Avibhuta Ramana Viti, by When about Anuruddha, who wrote the Abhidhamma, not the Sangha, and we translate this, not this as my book, the essence of Abhidhamma, we call it. Now in the Avibhuta Ramana Viti, the sense object is of slight intensity, no? And appearance of the mind door is not clear as in the above two cases. Thus, after not the life continuum is arrested, Mano Dwara Vajana Cheta occurs three times, trying to observe and decide whether the sense object is good or bad. But the object is not precisely known, and consequently no Javana Cheta occur to enjoy the taste of the sense object. So Abda Mano Dwara Vajana Bhinga Cheta sinks into life continuum, that means Bhinga Cheta keeps on flying. Flowing. This viti is called Vattapana Vara viti, as it terminates with the Mano Dwara Vajana, which is also called Vattapana. So in the fourth one, we call it Ati Vibhuta Ramana viti. The sense object is of very slight intensity. It can only cause the life continuum to vibrate twice without the cutting of the Bhringa stream. So no viti chitta arise, and then the sense object is not known at all. So it is deprived of cognitive consciousness. It is also called moga vara viti. Okay. No? So we finish the 10. So very good. We can stop here. So tomorrow we can see about the Javana Viti and the Lugutra Viti tomorrow.
Two.